हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सारस्वत इंटरनेशनल एकेडमी। दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10 मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 3 एंड द टॉपिक इज पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल। सो वी विल स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर इन दिस वीडियो। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल pair of linear equation in two variable we have to know about. Now what is the linear equation? First of all, we have to define the linear equation for two variable and then we will discuss about the pair. So we know that an equation which can be put in the form of ax plus by plus c equals to 0, again ax plus by plus c is equals to 0, where x and y are two variables, for linear their power should be 1 or degree should be 1. So the standard form will be ax plus by plus c equals to 0, where you can say a and b and c are real numbers and a and b are not 0, both 0 is called a linear equation in two variable x and y. So this is the standard format of a linear equation in a two variable with variable x, y. You can also get p, q, r, s, t, u. So you can get m, n, a, b as form a linear equation in two variable. So variable can be changed in a form of x, y, p, q, r, z, a, t, b, y, a, x or a, b. In such a way you can use any variables, but in this equation we will use x and y. Again, you have also studied that the solution of a such equation is a pair of a values on 4 x and the 1 4 y, which makes the two sides of the equation equal. So again, you know that solution of a linear equation, you have already studied this topic in 9th standard, that the solution of a linear equation, that pair of values of x and y which makes both sides of equation are equal, that LHS will be equals to RHS. So how it can be happen? Let's take some examples. For example, I am taking equation 2x plus 3y equals to 5. So what is in my LHS? It is 2x plus 3y. And what will be my RHS? Equals to 5. So we have to put two values of x and y and check whether it will become 5 or not. So for that, let us substitute x equals to 1 and y equals to 1 in the left hand side. So it will become left hand side equals to 2 into 1 plus 3 into 1, which will become 2 plus 3 and it is equals to 5. So what we have seen, that which is equals to its RHS or right hand side. So what we can say, that x equals to 1 and y equals to 1 is the solution for the equation 2x plus 3y equals to 5. Now again checking any one value. So for that, let substitute x equals to 1 and y equals to 7 in the equation. So what will get I in LHS? So LHS will become 2 into 1 plus 3 into 7 equals to 2 plus 21, which is equals to 23. And we can see it is not equals to its right hand side. So what we can say, that 1 and x equals to 1 and y is equals to 7 is not a solution of the equation. So what is the solution of the equation? The ordered pair of values of x, y, which makes LHS equals to RHS. Now again the next topic, that geometrically what does this mean? It means to say, what is the solution mean geometrically? So for the solution, what we have to do, it means that the point 1, 1 lies on the line representing the equation 2x plus 3y equals to 5. And the point 1, 7 does not lie on it. So geometrically 1, 1 point lie on the line which is given 2x plus 3y plus 5, but 1,7 does not lie on it. So it is the geometric meaning of a solution. So now what we have to do? So every solution of the equation is a point on the line represented by it. So every solution is a point on the line representing it. Now, so let us see what such pairs of look like algebraically. So if we are talking about the pair of linear equations, so how it will be elaborated or why how we can write it. So the general form for the pair of linear equation in two variable x and y is, so we are using variable x, y, you can also use a, b, p, q, r, s, something. So it is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. So I am just changing the coefficients. In the first example we have write just ax plus by plus c, but there are two pairs, so I will write a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0, where you can say a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2 are all real numbers, but and a1, b1 and a2, b2 not the zero value. A1, a2 and b1, b2 will be non-zero numbers, or maybe only one number can be zero, but not all numbers are become zero. So again, some examples for the pair of linear equation we will learn. So two variable equation, and we have to write a pair, so we have to write two equations for it. So the first equation is 2x plus 3y minus 7 equals to 0 and 9x minus 2y plus 8 equals to 0. This is the two different equation. You have just seen that only the coefficients are and the constant term are changed, nothing, the variable is as it is. The next example we can write 5x equals to y and minus 7x plus 2y plus 3 equals to 0. This is also a form of a linear equation. The next example is x plus y equals to 7 and 17 equals to y. This is also an example. So what you have seen in this example, the first example a1 b1 c1 and a2 b2 c2 are non-zero constant. In a second example c1 is 0 and other all values are real numbers. In the third example the a2 is 0 and other numbers are non-zero numbers. So you can write a1 b1 c1 and a2 b2 c2 are non-zero real numbers, or except one value all others are non-zero. So this is the form you have to write the standard format of pair of linear equation. So you have to write the pair of equation, two equations for a linear value. Now what will happen? Do you know what they look like geometrically? So how we can use the pair of linear equation geometrically? So first of all we have find the algebraic method. Now we have to discuss about the geometrically the meaning of the pair of linear equation. So recall that in 9th standard you have studied that the geometrically representation of a line or linear equation in a two variable is a straight line. You have studied in the 9th class, or you have drawn the graph of a linear equation in two variable, and you remember that it is a straight line. So there will be two straight lines, both be considered together. Following three possibilities can happen. So whenever there are two straight lines in the geometrically, then both considered together, we have to consider the both graphs together. So you have to remember these follow these three possibilities can happen. The first one, that both line will be, or the two lines will intersect each other at single common point or one point. The second case, the two lines will not intersect, like they are parallel. Or the third case, टू लाइन्स विल बी कोइंसाइड कोइंसिडेंट सो दे विल कोइंसिडेंट विद ईच अदर. सो दीज थ्री केसेस, फर्स्ट इंटरसेक्ट एट वन पॉइंट, नेवर इंटरसेक्ट और पैरेलल, एंड द थर्ड विल बी कोइंसिडेंट. सो हाउ दे विल लुक, सो आई एम गिविंग सम एग्जाम्पल टू हाउ दे विल लुक इन द ग्राफ. We show all these examples or possibilities in the given figure. So the first figure is, this figure represents the line which are intersecting lines. So they intersect. The second graph will show that these lines will become the parallel lines or non-intersecting lines. And the third case, you have seen the two lines are overlapped with each other, so we can say these are coincident lines. So these three kinds of line you will know for the cases. So now we will discuss some examples for it also, that how we can get this line. So for that I am taking one example, one that Akhila went to a fair in her village. She wanted to enjoy rides on the giant wheel and play hoopla. The number of times she played hoopla is half of the number of the rides she had on the giant wheel. If each ride cost rupees 3 and a game of a hoopla cost rupees 4, how would they you find out the number of rides she had and how many times she played hoopla, provided that she spent rupees 20. So you have three datas. The first data is that number of times she played hoopla is half of the number of rides. Then cost of a giant wheel is 3, cost of a hoopla is 4, and the total expense is 20 rupees. So how we can find this number? So what we have to do? Let's find the solution for it. So this is a one kind of word problem. First of all, you have to identify how we can convert any word problem to the mathematical form. So what we have? So let x is the number of times he sits on a giant wheel, and y is the number of times play. So we are assuming that x is a number of rides on a giant wheel and y is a number of times play hoopla. So now what relation we have? That number of times he played hoopla is half of the number of rides in a giant wheel. We have the relation. So in a place of a number of times of hoopla, we will put y, and in a place of number of rides of a giant wheel, we can put x. So my equation will become y is equals to 1 by 2 into x. Now taking 2 as LCM, I will get 2y is equals to x. Now taking 2y towards the right hand side, I will get my first equation, which is x minus 2y equals to 0. So this is the algebraic method for the first one. This is the first equation. We have to find two pairs. So now how we can find the second pair, second equation? So we have the cost price, the cost of a ride and the cost of a hoopla, and the total amount he spent. So for that, what we have to do? Let 3 times of number of times in a giant wheel plus 4 into number of times play hoopla is equals to 20. So how I can find it? That 3 rupees into the number of times he plays giant wheel plus 4 times number of times he play hoopla, the total cost will be 20 rupees. So putting x and y, again I will get 3x plus 4y equals to 20. So this is the two equation we have derived. Now what happen if I have to let representing this equation graphically? So if we have to draw the graph of this equation, how we can draw it? So I am taking the first value y is equals to 1 by 2 into x, and the second equation will be 3x plus 4y equals to 20. Now making two values, first put x equals to 0, then put y equals to 0, or you can find the following values by table method. You have already find this method in a 9th standard, that find equation draw the graph of linear equation in two variable, but here you can know how we can find it. The second points you can find like this. The second points will be this one. So first we'll go at 0, 0 is the first point, and 2, 1 is the second point for the first equation. And for the second equation, first point is 0, 5, second point is 20/3, 0, and the third point is 4, 2. So how the graph will look like for it? So now the graph will be look like this. This is the graph for the following equation. So here we can see the first graph passing from 0, 0 and 4, 2. Another graph will pass from again 4, 2 and 0, 5. So what you have seen, the lines are intersecting at point 4, 2. So you can see that, observe that the two lines representing the two equations are intersecting at the point 4, 2. So we can say these lines are intersecting lines. Now for the second type, we are taking one other example. Example number 2. Romila went to a stationery shop and purchased 2 pencils and 3 eraser for ₹9. Her friend Sonali saw the new varieties of pencils and erasers with Romila, and she also bought 4 pencils and 6 eraser of the same kind for ₹18. Now represent this situation algebraically and graphically. So we have to first of all find equation for it, and then we have to find the graph for it. So for the solution, what we have to do? Assume that the cost of one pencil by ₹x and of one eraser by ₹y. So first equation will be 2 pencils, so it will become 2x, and plus 3 erasers, so it will become 3y, and the total cost is 9. So if we have to write the following algebraic representation of the given data, the first equation will be 2x plus 3y equals to 9, and for second equation there are 4 pencils, so it will become 4x, and 6 erasers will become 6y, and the total will be 18. So my second equation will become 4x plus 6y equals to 18. So this is the algebraic representation of the given data. Now for the graph, we have to build up a points also. So for that, to obtain the equivalent geometric representation, what we have to do? We have to find the points for the graph. The first point is 2x plus 3y equals to 9. Now drawing the graph for it, I will get the following data: 0, 3 and 4.5, 0. And for the second equation, 4x plus 6y is equals to 18. What this following simplification, you will get another 2 points, 0, 3 and 3, 1, the another two solution. So what will be happen here, that whenever I will make graph for it, my graph will be look like this. So what you have seen, that both graph are coincident because they are overlap with each other. So both graphs are coincident lines. So what you have observed, that we find that the both lines coincident each other. So now why will it happen? This is so because the both equations are equivalent. How they are equivalent? If I am taking 2 common from the second equation, the first equation and second equation will be equal. So they are equivalent equation. Whenever you find some constant and if you remove it and it is similar to other equation, you can say the both equations are equal. So this is the second example. Now taking the third example, the example number 3. Two rails are represented by the equation x plus 2y minus 4 equals to 0 and 2x plus 4y minus 12 equals to 0. Represent these situations geometrically. So geometrically or graphically, both words can be used. So what you have to do for the solution, first of all you have to find points for it. So for x plus 2y minus 4 equals to 0, my point will be like this. The first point will be 0 comma 2, the other point will be 4 comma 0. Now for the second one, 2x plus 4y minus 12 equals to 0, the following points you can get, again 0 comma 3 and 6 comma 0. Now draw the graph for it. So we will get a graph like this. This is the graph of the following two lines. So what do you see? The lines are not intersecting at any points. You can observe this graph will be the lines parallel to each other. This is the third example. Now moving towards the exercise. So here the first exercise 3.1. Now the first question is, Aftab tells his daughter, 7 years ago I was 7 times as old as you were then. Also, 3 years from now I shall be 3 times as old as you will be. So what is Aftab tells his daughter? That 7 years ago age of Aftab will be 7 times of his age of his daughter, and from 3 years from now Aftab age will be 3 times of age of his daughter. So what we have to do? Represent this situation algebraically and graphically. So what I am doing, I am just deriving the algebraic form for this question. For the graphical one, I have given you the homework. You have to draw the both graphs in the same graph paper, and you have to observe that line are intersecting, non-intersecting or parallel or coincident line. So what we have to do for the solution, let assuming that present age of Aftab is x years and present age of his daughter is y years. So we are assuming the present age of Aftab is x years and the present age of his daughter is y years. The first case, for 7 years ago ages, Aftab will be x minus 7 years and his daughter's age will be y minus 7 years. So age of Aftab relation is, age of Aftab is equals to 7 times of age of his daughter for this case. So x minus 7 is equals to 7 into y minus 7. So next it will become x minus 7 is equals to 7y minus 49. Divide the next simplification, 7y will take toward the right hand side. So it will become x minus 7y minus 42 equals to 0. So this is my first equation. Now for the case of the second case, that for the 3 years from the present age, now Aftab age will be x plus 3, his daughter's age will be y plus 3. So now age of Aftab is 3 times of the age of his daughter. So x plus 3 equals to 3 times of y plus 3. So x plus 3 is equals to 3y plus 9. After simplification, I will get it is x minus 3y minus 6 equals to 0. So this is the two equation we have required for it. So now the graphical situation is your homework. You have to just draw the graph of two lines on the same graph paper and check whether it is intersecting, parallel or coincident line. Now for other two questions for this exercise, in this exercise there are only three questions. The first question we have discussed. Now the other two questions are this. The second is, the coach of the cricket team buys 6 bats and 6 balls for rupees 3900. Later she buys a bat and 2 balls for same kinds for 1300. Represent this situation graphically and algebraically. So you have to assume that cost of a bat is a x and cost of ball is y, and represent this equation by the given example we have already discussed. Again, the second question is same, that cost of 2 kg apples is and 1 kg grapes on a day is 160. After a month, the cost of 4 kg apples and 1 kg of 2 kg of grapes is 300. Represent this situation is algebraically and geometrically. So what you have to assume? That cost of 1 kg apples is x and cost of 1 kg grapes is y. So 2x plus y equals to 160, and the second equation will be 4x plus 2y equals to 300, and this two equation will be derived. So these two questions will be your homework. You have to do both things. First of all, derive this equation and then draw the graph of both equation. So in this video we will just discussing that how you can create the equation and how you can draw its graph. In next video we will discuss about more on this chapter. Thank you.